How do you go in translating like the scenery, the environment? What goes into translating that? What factors do you consider? Like, how do you translate such this complex? You have the sound effects, you have the rain, you have screaming. How does all of that come together and turn into like the series of actions that you interpret? Because as far as I'm aware, FSL and other sign languages, they aren't exactly one-to-one. There's a lot of creative freedom that goes into creating the different signs. So as a hearing person with no experience with FSL, I just want to understand what's the rationale behind it and how are they supported.
Again, I love your question, kanina nga I'm telling Miss Karen, I hope someone asks me about the process. And the process of creating this is, well, firstly, I watch deaf people and their how they storytell. And I noticed that when they tell a story, they don't just say the dialogue, they say what's happening, they set up the space, they set up the time, they set up the entire environment, which is something indicative of a visual language as opposed to an auditory language. So in terms of this, the process of making these scenes, first I broke down the scenes into workable chunks. And like I said before, we have deaf consultants partnering with us, giving us feedback, giving us ways and approaches on how to attack the interpretation. So sa kanila mismo, nagsasabi, sige, especially if there's like a calming, like there's still silence, but you still see that there's movement, there's still something happening, because there is, from a deaf person's, a deaf world perspective, something is happening. And if you can see, like it's almost like synchronous choreography when the interpreter is matching also the environment, right? It's a visual parang feast for the eyes when you see something linguistically accurate to what's happening in the scene. So dun nagkakaroon ng those are where I get those choices. The challenging part is the role shifting. So when there's various characters, instead of me just being one character, I am all the characters, right? So in order to convey each character, I have to give them a little bit of a distinction. Iba yung pitik or something. Sometimes it's even just a slight shoulder shrug, right? Or if I'm a mother, I'm talking to a child like this, and I'm the child, now I'm talking to my mother like this. So that's a role shift. So that's how I break down every single chunk. I break it down into every single scene and every single nuanced line. So madugo siya. But if you're inclined in language and so interested in sign language and how the linguistics of it works, it's fun, right? Especially if you have other deaf people to parang mag-bato-bato, ito maganda to, mas maganda tong approach na ganito. So I hope this sparks like an interest in sign language, kasi I'm always promoting then that especially for young people, your brains are more malleable and you have a lot more gray matter. So languages come like that to you guys compared to like older people. We need more interpreters like you. So if this is another direction, I really encourage you to learn more sign language, learn more about the deaf community, but learn it from deaf people. Right? It's better to have a deaf teacher rather than a hearing teacher. So yun yung process. I hope I was not too technical, but I really made the deaf people lead. So a lot of my choices came from what feedback they gave me, and that's what they wanted, is to have some sort of it's like a continuous performance. Sa deaf kasi, meron silang heightened ang tawag doon, peripheral vision. Alam mo yon? So when they're driving a car, they can see the rear view mirror and hear without moving their eye. It's like their peripheral vision is ang laki. You can ask a deaf person, saan yung church? Ah, dun lang. And everybody will point at the right direction because they have that spatial awareness. When one of your senses is gone, the other senses talaga they enhance. So that being said, yung visual ng death is where I try to focus the interpretation on. So I hope that makes sense.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Sir
Anong
Bayani,
oras? Please na.
for
Please na.
59.
Ah, it's okay.
Okay lang.
Sorry, may nag-echo lang.
And for good afternoon, good evening, good afternoon. Yeah. I am from NCDA po, National Council on Disability Affairs. Hi po, my name is Asher. And I commend everyone na natutuwa nito from Edoxine and sa inyo po sa nag-interpret sa natutuwa. And comment lang, sinasabit naman na kanina kung ano yung tanong ko dapat talaga is paano yung process. Kasi sinusundan din talaga eh. At walang cuts. Yeah. Kung may cuts man yun lang sa fade in yata, fade out. Kaya napaka comment lang sana na ano, magkaroon tayo talaga ng archival ng ganitong mga pelikula na may interpreters. Kasi napaka-importante rin yan na maging inclusive yung pananood sa pelikula. Kaya ayun, napakagaling lang din po talaga. Kasi ako, nakapanood ako ng mga interpreters. I have friends na interpreters. And first time ko rin makapanood ng pelikula na may FSL. Ayun nga, sabi nga kanina eh, napakagaling kasi nga it's a performance. Para kang sumasayaw. Even yung pagpasok sa eksena. At ayun, napakagaling po. Kaya, thank you po sa inyo lahat na buo dito. Ayun lang po.
Thank you din sa inyo and I really look forward to working with you. And yes, let's make it happen. Let's create an archive. Let's create a library. I'm all for more access and I'm sure that we'll definitely work together in the future. But just to comment din dun sa ano sa mga interpreter na nawala yung inset, that was actually a choice then. Kasi while we were looking at the scene and we wanted to focus on the love story of Tanabata and her wife, and so we wanted to take out the interpreter para yung full focus. So not just, we didn't just try to fill in space, we tried to be mindful about what space to fill, right? And you know, maganda nga yung turnout. I really am proud of the interpretation dito sa Tanabata's wife. But yes, I really appreciate you, sir, and your interest. And yun nga, I hope to see you in the future for sure. And I hope you're interested in interpreting. May mga friends ka na interpreters, baka gusto mo din.
Pwede naman, sir.
Sige.
Kukuha ng certification for FSL.
Give applause.
May question pa ba? Okay, sige. Kung wala ng question, I'll just end. Ako na yung magbigay ng ending message kasi Sir Bayani needs to go for his interview. Sir Bayani, kita kits later sa last talk. Thank you.
See you. Thank you po.
Okay, sige. Ako na yung mag-end.
Gusto mo
mag-picture? Ay, picture pala, picture. Yes. Gallery ko lang. Ayan. Photo op muna daw, guys, before Sir Bayani leaves. Ganito, guys. Paano, sir? Paano?
Ito, I love you. Ito, rock and roll.
Okay.
Ito din yung ano, devil sign. So,
ganito na lang.
The more you learn. Ganito
paano
na lang.
Pag ganito?
Kasi ito yung letter I. Ito yung letter L, ito yung letter Y. So, I love you.
Paano pag ganito?
You love yourself. So, it's directional. I love you. I love myself. I love all of you.
Game na yata.
Game na? Okay, game.
Thank
Kayo
you.
po.
Thank you, guys. Pwedeng pakausap kay Sir Joe. Hello, sir. Thank you, sir. Hi, sir. Yeah, I'm Karen po from Edoxine. I'm the founder and CEO. And yun po, ako po yung nakaisip ng project na to. And last year ko pa po siyang gustong gawin. And unfortunately, yung partner na gusto kong itap, sobrang busy yung binil. Pero ko si Sir Bayani kasi nag-viral siya dun sa Coldplay concert. So,
Oo nga po.
message ko siya, ayun, go agad. Kaya we were able to push.
Registration Yes po. Po, napakaganda nga po. Actually, nakuha ko rin yung letter from Sir Roger. Binigay ko na agad siya sa executive director namin. Kasi lagi rin ako nanonood ng Edoxine. Actually, yung last na Edoxine ko was yung... Ano ba yun? I forgot. Tapos, yun. Tapos, madalas din ako dito. Kaya, ayun, napakaganda. Actually, pinag-uusapan din namin sa office if po pwede nga maging partner sa Edoxine.
Yes, yeah,
To
sige po.
archive na meron tayo mga pelikula na may FSL.
Ah, ayun po sir, baka we can also partner like to bring this film sa mga communities na mga schools, mga other offices na kakilala ninyo kasi ang clients namin mostly government offices like you kasi meron silang budget yung GAD, yung Gender and Development. So, lagi namin kapartner yung iba't ibang government offices all over the Philippines, even Philippine Embassy. So, right now,
Sige, sige ma'am. If ever, pwede naman tayo na makapag-usap regarding doon. Looking forward to work with you sa susunod. Sa 19 po, pupunta yung mga taga-NCBA dito. So, manonood sila.
Sige po.
Ngayon kasi
Sir,
medyo...
pa-help na lang po kami to promote. So, medyo kasi karamihan nung yung mga audience ata na deaf, baka tomorrow pa or next week. So, pa-help na lang kami to spread the good news po. And this is not the first and the last na may ganitong event. And looking forward na if we can have more budget, we can have more films na may FSL. Kasi itong gastos, sariling gastos namin to.
Sige po.
Project
And then,
na.
Actually, tinanong ko na kay Sir Roger kung ano ba yung participation namin or kung may tutulong ba kami. Kaso parang ayun nga, sobrang close din sa date nung nalaman namin. Kaya
Sir, we can
hindi kami
organize our
din.
own. Baka we can bring it to your office.
Sige po. Okay.
We
Baka
can
makapag-happening
organize a
tayo ng
Friday
party.
Black screening. Pwede dito sa UP or pwede possible online. Kasi ilalagay din
Sige
namin
po, sige po.
Edoxine. Sige
Ako po
sir.
pala yung media specialist ng NCDA.
Nice to meet you po. Sige po. Thank you po.
Thank you po. Thank you po.
Thank you.
May audience na po.
Ah, sige, papasokin mo na. Stop ko na yun.